Very good morning to one and all. Today I am going to discuss about the residential status of an individual. So before that, I myself, Dr. K. Srinivasan, Assistant Professor, Department of Commerce, SRM Institute of Science and Technology, Ramapuram Chennai. Today we are going to discuss about the most important topic in the income tax, the residential status of an individual. Generally in India, the tax liability to be determined based on the residential status. The residential status, it is the most important thing. Then only we can able to compute the tax liability of an individual. Today we are following a progressive rate of tax system to be implemented by the government. According to Income Tax Act 1961, explained that the tax liability to be determined based on the residency status. So the residency status, it is a most important topic. It is most important for exam point of view. So students should know clearly about the residency status of an individual. Then only you can able to determine the tax liability. So the first, the residency status can be classified into under three category. The first category is resident, or it is also called as ordinary resident. Then second one, resident but not ordinary resident. And third one is non-residents. So based on the determination of residential status is based on the certain rule. That is, there are two rules are to be followed for determining the residential status. The first rule is the basic condition. The second rule is additional condition. These two rules are most important to be determine the residential status of an individual. The first one, the basic condition is a stay of 182 days or more during the current previous year. That means our current previous year is 2021 and 2022. So the person should stay in India during the previous year. At least 182 days or more. This is the first basic condition. Second one, a stay of 60 days or more in the current previous year and a total stay of 365 days or more in the 4 years immediately preceding the current year. So the person, the second basic condition is he should stay in India during the previous year is 60 days and 365 days or more during the previous preceding 4 years. So these are the basic two conditions. Then another one is additional condition. It is also most important one for determining the residential status. The additional condition is he should be resident in India in at least 2 out of 10 years immediately the preceding the previous year. That means what? He should stay in India minimum 2 years out of 10 years preceding the previous year. Then second one is he should stay 735 days or more during the 7 years preceding the current year. That means the another condition is 730 days or more during the current preceding previous year. Current 7 years preceding the current year. So these are the basic conditions. Now we can very easy to check out whether he is a resident or ordinary resident or resident but not ordinary resident and non-resident. You can able to check that. This is called what? Resident. This is resident but not ordinary resident. Then non-resident. So we can give the basic condition. There are two basic conditions, 1 and 2. Additional condition also 1 and 2. The first one is basic, who is resident? That means a person fulfilling any one of the basic condition. A person fulfilling any one of the basic condition, that person is called resident. The residency is also classified into ordinary resident. So ordinary resident means a person fulfilling any one of the basic condition and also satisfying both additional condition. Ordinary resident means any one individual fulfilling any one of the basic condition and also fulfilling both additional condition is called as resident, that means ordinary resident. Then who is resident but not ordinary resident means a person fulfilling the basic condition, any one of the basic condition, but not fulfilling the any one of the additional condition. That means what? None of the additional condition. That person is called resident but not ordinary resident. The last one is non-resident. Who is non-resident? That means a person failed to fulfilling the basic condition. The person is failed to fulfilling any one of the basic condition. That person is called non-resident. So the determination of residential status, it is most important one to determine the income of the individual. So it is most important topic. So your student, you should aware about the basic condition as well as the additional condition, then only you can able to classify whether he is a resident or not resident, not ordinary resident, a resident but not ordinary resident and non-resident. So students, you should know clearly about the basic as well as the additional condition. It is most important. So based on that you can classify. The resident means resident, ordinary resident, a person fulfilling any one of the basic condition and also fulfilling both additional conditions, that it is called as resident. Resident, ordinary resident means a person fulfilling the basic condition alone. He is not fulfilling the any one of the additional condition. It is called resident but not ordinary resident. Non-resident means a person failed to fulfilling the basic condition. If the person is failed to fulfilling the basic condition, the person is called as non-resident. So thank you for watching. Thank you once again.